Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. Today in this video I am explaining linear algebra concepts. The most important topics in linear algebra is first one is matrices, second one is vector spaces, and the third one is linear transformation. Linear transformations, and fourth one is system of linear equations. System of linear equations, and fifth one is diagonalizability. Diagonal. These are the topics important for KSET, CSRNET, and DU, BHU. And many other MSc entrance examinations. In this video, in this concept of linear algebra, I am detailedly explaining the concepts of linear algebra and as well as important topics in linear algebra, and I detailedly give the concept of linear algebra with examples and previous year's questions. First, we move on to basics, important tools, basics for linear algebra, basics, important tools for linear algebra are matrices. We know that first one is A square is equal to 0. The simplest A is equal to 0. Tell me, first important tool is if I am not given any definition for matrices, I am not given the any basics introduction for matrices, because you all are already studied about matrices definition, what is row sum, what is row, what is column, and what is matrices and types of matrices you already studied. But in this linear algebra explanation part, I am only give the most important topics, that is matrices, what is the important for matrices topics, and special types of matrices, that is idempotent, nilpotent, and symmetric and skew symmetric, diagonal matrices like that, and eigenvalues like that topics I am explaining detailedly, and that topics enough for any examination. That topics are most important, that's why I am explaining that topics only. Okay, I will come to our concept. A square is equal to 0, this simple as A is equal to 0. Tell me. Okay, now you take the one example. Suppose we take one matrix, any 2 by 2 matrix, 0, 0, 1, 0, and we take A square, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, this implies 0, 0, 0, 0, we get 0, 0, but A is equal to 0, 0, 0, no, therefore, whereas A not equal to 0, according to this A is equal to 0, but this implies A is not equal to 0. A is not equal to 0. Okay, we come to second tool, important tool. If A and B are square matrices, of same order, then AB is equal to 0, this implies A is equal to 0, or B is equal to 0. Tell me, if A and B are square matrices, what is square matrices? Square matrices means number of columns is equal to number of rows. That type of matrices we call as square matrices. If they are given A and B are two square matrices of same order, then AB is equal to 0, this implies A is equal to 0, or B is equal to 0. Question mark. Now, one if you take one example, we take one example. Simply, we take an example. A is equal to 1000, and B is equal to 0010. We take the product of these matrices. AB is equal to 1000 and 0100. We get 0000. The product we get AB is equal to 0, but neither A is equal to 0 nor B is equal to 0. What is this meaning? A is not equal to 0 and B is not equal to 0, but we get AB is equal to 0. If any two square matrices of same order, then AB is equal to 0. This does not imply A is equal to 0 or B is equal to 0. Now we move on to another tool, that is third one. If A is equal to 1011, then A4 of n is equal to what? They are asking what is the value of A4 of n? They are asking what is the value of A4 of n? Now we take simply 2 powers up to 2 powers, that is we take a square, that 1101 and 1101, we get 1, we adding this 1 and this 1, we get here 2 and 0, here also 0 and 0 plus 1, we get here 1. Then we take a third power a cube, this equal to a square into a, this equal to 1201, and what is a? 1101. This equal to 1 and 2 plus 1, that is 3, and 0 plus 0, we get 0 only. 0 plus 1, we get 1. What we conclude here? Therefore, A4 of n is equal to 1n 0 1. We get this is, see the here, the power of A is 1, we get here 1, and power of 2 is a power of A is 2, then we get here 2. Here what is the power of A is 3, here we get here 3. Then therefore A4 of n is equal to 1n 0 1, where n belongs to natural numbers. This starting from the powers starting from 1, 2, 3 and so on. That's why n belongs to natural number. This is the required answer. We move on to another important tool. If A is equal to 1, 1, 1, 1 and so 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 and so 1, 1 and so 1, 1, 1, 1 and so 1, 1. This is n by n matrix. In the matrix contain all the entries 1, then what is the value of A square? What is the value of A square? This is the problem asked in IASC examination, IASC IR mathematics exam. These are the most important matrix. This is the important matrix in many exams. Randomly asking this type of matrices every year. This is the most important topic. All the matrix containing all the entries 1 1 1, then A square is equal to, they are asking why value of A square. Now we examine the given matrix. For suppose we take any 3 by 3 matrix. We take 3 by 3 matrix, that is 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, and we take the A square, we get 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 and 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, and we take the product 1 1 1, we get all the entries 3 3 3 3 3 3. After multiplication we get all the entries 3. then we take the 3 as common, we get 3 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 this equal to what is nothing but this matrix, all the entries, this equals to A na, therefore 3A, we get 3A. Then we again take, if we take, suppose if you take 4 by 4 matrix, we consider 4 by 4 matrix, therefore A square is equal to 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 and 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1. We take all the entries, 4 by 4 by 4 matrix, we adding, we get 4 4 4 4 4, we get all the entries 4, then we take 4 as common, then again we get original matrix, then this equal to, this matrix equal to A, therefore we get 4A. Then we conclude that we see this after writing these all, now we conclude A square is equal to N A. A square is equal to N A. Because we observe that, why we taken A square is equal to N A? Because we observe that in 4 by 4 matrix, we considered a 4 by 4 matrix, then we again get here 4 into A. This is 4 by 4 matrix. We get as 4A. We considered 2 by 3 by 3 matrices, we consider 3 by 3 matrices, we get here also 3 by 3 and 3 by 3, then we get 3A. Like that we take any order, we take any 5 by 5 or 6 by 5 or and so on up to n by n matrices, so we get A square as N A. This is the correct answer. Then we move on to another tool, that is the fifth tool. These tools are very important for solving problems in a linear algebra. Fifth tool is, if A is equal to 0 1 1 0, then A power of n, what is the value of A power of n? They are asking the value of A power of n. This is not identity matrix. You not confuse about this matrix, because this is not identity matrix. Okay, we take suppose we take A square, that is 0 1 1 0 and 0 1 1 0, we get 0 plus 1, we get 1, 0 plus 0, here 0, 0, and we get 0 here, and 1 plus 0, we get 1. This equals to identity matrix. Now we get identity matrix. Then we again take A cube, this is equal to A square into A. This is 1, 0, 0, 1, and 0, 1, 1, 0, this is equal to 0 plus 0, we get 0 here, 1 plus 0, here we get 1, and 0 plus 1, we get 1, and 0 plus 0, we get here 0. We get original matrix, that is A, that is original matrix, that means A cube is equal to A, we get, we again take A4 of 4 is equal to A square into A square. That equal, what is A square value? We get identity, I into I, what is the value of product of two identity matrices? We again get identity only. That means we conclude that, now we conclude that therefore the A power of n value, we conclude that if I n is even, we get answer as I. If n is odd, we get answer as A. Observe that in even power, we get answer as identity, and in odd power we get answer as a. That's why you conclude directly this a power of n is equal to I, n is even and n is odd. Now we take one question. If a is equal to minus 1, 2, 2, 3 and b is equal to 3, 0, 1, 1, then a plus b whole square is equal to option a is a square plus 2ab plus b square, and option b is a square plus ab plus ba plus b square, and option c is both a and b, and option d is none. These are the options given. Now we have to solve the a plus b whole square form. Generally we know that formula for a plus b whole square, that is we written as this as a square plus b square plus 2ab, but this is wrong method. This is not good way. This is the not correct way to solve a plus b whole square, but we studied in school days directly by using a plus b whole square formula, but in we come to the higher level we cannot use this. Like we take a plus b whole square, what is the actual meaning of a plus b whole square? Means a plus b and a plus b, we take like this first. We cannot take like this. This is the wrong approach. We cannot take like this. Then we take a into a and ab plus ba and b into b. Now we add we take product a square plus ab plus ba plus, and we take b square, we take like this. Then a square is equal to, these are 2ab plus b square. When this is possible, this is only possible if and only if ab is equal to ba. If and only if ab is equal to ba, then we take 2ab. Otherwise this is not possible. If ab is equal to ba, then we only take 2ab. Otherwise this is not possible. We generally be written as a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. If and only if ab is equal to ba, this is the condition. If they given this condition, they definitely this is correct. But if they didn't given this condition, this is wrong. We take like this. Then we move on to our problem. Then options a is a square plus 2b, we don't know this is correct or wrong, and option b a square plus ab plus ba plus b square, this is 100% correct. This is the 100% correct. This option, we don't know both a and b are correct, b is correct. Then we check option a is correct or not. They given a as minus 1 and 2 and 2 and 3, and option b is 3 0 1 1. They given a and b. Now we take product a b is equal to minus 1 2 2 3 and 3 0 1 1. We get minus 3 plus 2 minus 3 plus 2 and 0 plus 1 and 6 plus 3 and 0 plus 3, we get like this, and we solving we get minus 1193. This is the AB value. Now we find B. Now we find BA value, that is 3011 and minus 1223. This equal to we get minus 3 plus 0, 6 plus 0, minus 1 plus 2, and 2 plus 3. Then we get minus 3, 6, and 1. This is 5. We get AB value is this and BA value is this. Therefore, we conclude that AB is not equal to BA. Therefore, this option is correct. Wrong, and this wrong, and this also wrong option. If this condition holds, AB is equal to BA, this condition holds, then definitely option A also correct and option C also correct. But in this question, AB not equal to BA, then we conclude that option A is wrong. If in question they given, suppose in the question they directly given AB, if and only if AB A plus B whole square is equal to value they asking, and if and only if AB is equal to BA, they given like that, then option A, option B and option C both are correct. Then we move on to final tool, last tool, that is A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square. We know that A plus B whole square is not equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square, and A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square, if and only if AB is equal to BA. If they given this condition, this equation is valid. This equation holds, and a plus b for third power a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3 a square b plus 3 b square a 3 a b square 3 a square b plus 3 a b square. If and only if a b is equal to B, if the condition satisfies, this equation holds, and we know that a plus b whole power of n by a plus b whole power of n, we know that binomial expansion if and only if a b is equal to b a, we take any power of a plus b, we must ensure this condition, that is AB is equal to BA. If this condition not given, that equation is absolutely wrong. If this condition holds, then the given equation is absolutely correct. Thanks for watching. In my next video, I am giving you some important questions asked in various examination regarding these tools, and important concepts and important questions solutions I give in next video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video.